Today I'm going to be talking about Play Dead by Ted Dekker. This is Dekker's first adult thriller that he's written in a minute. And if you've seen my videos recently, you'll see that I released a video about his book Showdown, where I just sort of had to talk about some of the crazy things that go down in that book. That video will be linked in the cards. But yeah, I just accidentally really wasn't thinking about it at all and released that video on the same day that Play Dead came out. And it just so happens, as I said, that this is Dekker's first thriller in a while. And so I was curious, hey, what has happened to Ted Dekker since I read his stuff? I think I read one of the series that he was working on back in like 2013. He had sort of been having a little bit of a spiritual different redirection. And I was curious how much things had changed and how well that would translate into this book. Because yeah, Ted Dekker is a Christian author who writes thrillers. I mentioned in the Showdown review that he's sort of the Christian equivalent of Stephen King, for better or worse. And this book looked like another thriller where it looks like there was a murder mystery going on, but things are not, you know, as obvious as they seem. And so, me knowing that is potentially my jam, and knowing that Dekker can sometimes throw some insane crap at you, I was like, let's do it. Let's talk about Play Dead. Because I knew virtually nothing about this book going in, the biggest surprise to me, something that was completely out of left field, was that this book is essentially like a science fiction thriller. And I mean science fiction not just because it uses technology, but science fiction in the way that it really explores philosophy and a theme having to do with technology. And it becomes apparent really fast, this book is about virtual reality and the consequences and effects that virtual reality may have on us in the real world. And it's very specific about its setting, and it's very on the nose with its setting. I mentioned before that Ted Dekker sometimes does things with a hammer. Let me give you an example. In the wake of a major pandemic that had crippled the world and the race wars that erupted out of that virus, virtual reality had become a safe way to navigate society. Okay, I see what you're doing. But honestly, aside from that sort of really front-loaded stuff, it's maybe potentially the most nuance I've ever seen Dekker storytelling. Because really, for the majority of this book, he is telling a, let's talk about virtual reality, the potential consequences of it, the way that this might come across in a thriller setting, where there, yeah, there's some conspiracy things going on. There's a lot having to do with like this murder mystery. But for Dekker, which is the guy who wrote Showdown, that video that I keep referencing, this is really tame, and it was really fun. You generally follow the perspectives of two characters, though sometimes there's additional point of views, as these characters try to solve the murder of these two teenagers that has something to do with virtual reality in a world where virtual reality is becoming this huge thing, and it's become extremely political on the effects of this, the potential side effects of this, whether it's okay, whether it's not okay. And as someone who sort of loves to experiment with the virtual reality technology that we already have, I love this thought. I love, well, frick, my favorite movie is The Matrix. These are themes that I love to explore, and I enjoy that we are getting to do that in the context of this fun murder mystery with these cool, intriguing elements. And like I said, short of the big real hammer blows at the beginning, Dekker handles this with a lot of fun nuance while still telling a good thriller story. And that was just the most surprising to me. Not that it was good, but that it was not so explosive in your face all the time. That isn't to say that there are awesome moments, because it is a thriller, but realize that I'm measuring this on a scale that's not like normal people scale. This is a Dekker scale. And the fact that some of the technological elements and the exploration of VR is done as well as it is, it shocked me in a good way. Like I said, I really enjoyed that aspect. Now, because it is a science fiction thriller, as the story goes along, it does escalate and it does reach some crazy levels. But because it's been so long since I've read a Dekker book and since Dekker has written a book, I feel like he has reset his equilibrium for what is a crazy plot in one of his stories. Now, one of the things that I mentioned in the previous video where I was talking about his catalog of stories is how he really likes to sometimes use religious allegories in his stories. Sometimes they're very good and poignant. Sometimes they're extremely non-subtle and heavy-handed. Like I said, for the majority of this book, I thought that the allusions to things were really good, and I didn't feel like it was feeling overly preachy on any specific religious point. And instead, it was really highlighting just the general philosophy of virtual reality and human existence, which are heady topics for sure. But I didn't feel like it was doing anything crazy on an allegorical or metaphorical sense, like anything extreme. That changes a bit when we get to the final conclusion, the final summary of the thesis of what Dekker is trying to say with this book. And I am the type of person that doesn't always think that, like, oh, just because the book says this doesn't mean that it's the author's opinion. The thing is different when analyzing Dekker books. One, because he frequently says what his themes are supposed to be, and two, because they're very obvious in his story that this is the message that he's trying to convey. One of my favorite comments on my earlier Dekker video was where someone described maybe what he was trying to do as bad Bible fan fiction. That is a hilarious comment, somewhat accurate for some of his other stories. I don't know if I would call what he does in this book bad Bible fan fiction, but I can't really talk about it that much without some spoilers. So those are my general thoughts on Play Dead by Ted Dekker. I think it's a really fun story. It's very enjoyable and makes you think a lot about the technological implications of virtual reality and what that means for humans and the way that we relate to each other, as well as some of the concerns that might come along with privacy, etc. I have to criticize some of the thematic elements of the book, though, and I have to do that with spoilers. So if you decide to stop watching the video now, thank you for watching. I'm glad that you showed up. I hope to see you again. There's links to everything down below, as always. Now I have to talk spoilers, and I have to talk about why I have a problem with this book. So spoilers are going to be starting in 3, 2, 1. Go. So first, as an aside, there are specific choices of language, turns of phrase that I don't love that Dekker uses in this book that are sometimes bothersome to people and sometimes not bothersome to people. Moving forward, I'm going to talk about the more problematic thematic elements to me. First, as I mentioned when I was talking about this stuff in the general section, there are a lot of allusions, like there are a lot of quotes that are taken from scripture that he sort of weaves into the narrative here that I don't even know if like non-Christians would recognize certain Bible verses and passages that he quotes in little regular random sentences throughout the book. But because he uses those, it's meant for, I think, Christians who are familiar with these passages of the Bible to draw parallels between the things that they know from the Bible and the passages that are being described. Most frequently, we're talking about passages like we're supposed to live in the world, but not of the world. A lot of this story is about seeing the truth through lots of lies and the illusions that exist in the world. There's also references to like becoming a new creation, old things are passed away, new things come. You know, this is like allusions to what happens to someone who is exposed to the truth of the gospel and puts their faith in God. This book tries to handle in a way, though, that is not as obvious, I think, to the people that don't believe in God. Like, it's not super, like, you don't have your Aslan character and you don't have your, like, Adam and Eve characters the way that you might have in some of the other passages. You don't have a Jesus character. And because of this story and the mystery involved and the virtual reality experience that we're dealing with, the way that he handles this is he's talking about seeing the truth through the lies, understanding the real world when there's virtual reality around us, understanding the implications of how someone who knows the truth might live differently than someone who does not know the truth. These are awesome themes, and I really actually like the ways that they were both obvious but semi-subtle compared to some of the ways that Dekker's handled some of these themes in the past. I think it's a very valid message for people living in the regular world. Some of these points really do hit home in a really interesting way. Here is my actual beef with the conclusion of the story. And I'm not the type of person that always picks apart themes in the books that I'm reviewing. There are a lot of books that I'm reviewing where I don't necessarily agree with major or minor themes in the book, and I don't always talk about them. Usually I try to talk about my general overall experience with the book, which I did at the beginning of this video, mostly positive. But because this is a Christian author supposedly writing a book presenting parts of Christianity, I feel like I have to criticize this major element of what he does with this theme in this book. In Christianity, the most important thing, like the gospel truth, it's actually called the gospel in Christianity. The thing you need to understand is that mankind is inherently flawed on a personal and a widespread level. Every single person has sin, and because of that sin being a reality, we need to be judged. We understand the world incorrectly, and we are living lives opposed to God and to truth and to right. This is the core of Christianity. We are broken. We are bad. We are inherently evil with a sin nature is what it's called. These are sort of the elements that the book explores. It touches on these subjects. It talks about us having to be able to see the truth through these lies. This is what it's talking about. It's talking about like getting a whole new worldview with which to see the world, which is the truth versus the false equivalency, which would be like humanism, which I would say is probably the predominant worldview these days, at least like in the Western culture. I want to once again reiterate, I don't expect the books that I read to just regurgitate what I believe back to me. But I feel like if someone is coming from a Christian perspective, trying to write a Christian book, supposedly pushing forward a Christian theme, it's important that they get that Christian theme correct. And here is where Decker goes with his version of this theme. And this is actually a quite common belief, but what I think is a very errant and extremely problematic belief coming from a Christian presented as Christianity. Which, hey, every book doesn't have to be pushing that, but if you're gonna push it as someone in the Christian camp, do it right. Here's what Decker says. Decker says that instead of our problem being this sin nature and our complete inability to see the truth on our own, we need to self-actualize and see the truth of reality, which is that we are perfect. And fear and mental blocks are the reason why all evil exists in the world. Like, we're afraid of each other, we're afraid of the unknown, we're not willing to be honest and open about the truth of ourselves. But the truth of ourselves in reality is that we are perfect the way that we are, and that by coming to this conclusion, that's how we start to see reality as it truly is. That's what allows us to live in the world but not of the world, to live the way that we're supposed to fully live to our potential, is to understand that we are perfect and just shed the negative feelings that we may have about ourselves. That's how we see everything as it really is. I think it's quite popular for people to have this worldview, to have the worldview that if we all just talk together and we were truly honest about what we were thinking and feeling, we would come together and the world would be magically made a better place. And I'm not against communication at all. I'm just extremely cynical because of my Christian worldview about the true nature and state of mankind. And while this book is extremely optimistic about the status of mankind and its ability to see truth on its own, I think that is antithetical to the Christian message and very, very bad to present as the Christian message. Very, very bad. So I'm so conflicted about this book because I don't think that books should be the medium that we use to just express these types of things. I don't think we should be looking at fiction to present to us accurate philosophical and theological texts. But if you write your book as a philosophical or theological statement, and that statement is wrong, I can't help but view it in that light. So like I said, while I enjoyed it as a thriller, by the time we got to the end, and this message was just so out there as someone who understood all of the subtext, I really, really have problems with the conclusions it comes to. Which has sort of been my problem with Decker's books that I alluded to in that showdown video. I think sometimes he goes off the rails with his themes. I think sometimes he tries to use a story metaphor so hard that it stops making good theological sense. And yeah, I'm one of those annoying nitpickers, but I think this is going beyond nitpicking and delving into just like, no, this is no. I hope this video made sense to people. I really wanted to talk about my thoughts on it because I am so conflicted and it makes me have this clash. If you're a Decker fan, have you sort of experienced this with some of his books in the past? Because I have. If you sort of don't know or don't care what I'm talking about, have you ever been reading a book and just had it present a theme where you're like, that's not the way the world works? And that bother you? That's sort of what happened here. Anyway, if you'd like to see more videos from me and you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe, hit the bell, get notifications when I post new videos. If you'd like to discuss this topic or anything else, there's a link down below to a Discord. If you'd like to support this channel financially, there is a link to a Patreon as well as a merch store in the description down below. I hope this video made some sense, but remember, I'm not your dad, but I am your best friend. Bye.
Sleep, no, I never get enough. Always looking out tired. Sleep, no, I never get enough. If I don't show up, I might get fired. Sleep, no, I never get enough. Always looking out tired, sleep. No, I never get enough. If I don't show up, I might get fired.